गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम संतोष कुमार, पीजीटी फिजिक्स फ्रॉम KB1 बठिंडा कैंट. टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी फॉलोइंग टॉपिक्स. द टॉपिक्स विल बी कंडक्टर्स, इंसुलेटर्स, फ्री चार्जेस एंड द बाउंड चार्जेस इनसाइड ए कंडक्टर. आफ्टर दिस वी विल स्टडी डाइलेक्ट्रिक्स एंड इलेक्ट्रिक पोलराइजेशन. सो फर्स्ट वी विल स्टार्ट विद our first topic, so we can divide a matter or a material mainly into three categories. The three categories are conductors, insulators and further semiconductors, right? So one by one we will study their definitions. First we will define conductors. The materials which can conduct electricity through them, we can say easily, are called as conductors. So what are the examples? We know so many examples in conductors. So we have copper material, aluminium, like gold, silver, even iron. So we can take so many examples. Out of these, or other than these, we know very well human body also comes under conductor category, or we can say earth is also a very good conductor. You must know so further. You want to know more about conductors, why these materials behave like a conductor, or you can say why these materials able to conduct electricity easily. So what is the reason behind that? You can write this reason by a note. As the materials like conductors are having free electrons available to move inside the material, and we know what is electricity. Electricity is basically the flow of charge per unit time. So these free electrons in the form of charges are easily conduct electricity because they easily able to move inside the material. So as the material like conductors having free electrons available to move inside the material, they able to conduct electricity, right? So now we will next define insulators. define insulators. The definition is very much clear. You must know those materials which not conduct electricity through them are called as insulators. We have examples of insulators like plastic, rubber, wood, etc. So many examples we can take regarding insulators. So again, you want to know why insulators have a property like this, they're not able to conduct electricity. So you can also write this in the form of note. So many students only know about that the insulators not able to conduct electricity, but they don't know exactly the reason behind that. So today we will study also the reason behind the behavior of insulators. So the first question comes that is electrons exist inside the insulators? So if I consider this insulator material of some plastic, so definitely you will agree this plastic material consists of atoms. Even every material consists of atoms. So in that way, we will agree this plastic material is also consists of atoms. So if this is consists of atom, then definitely every atom have electrons inside them. So now the question comes, if the material like plastic have electrons inside them, then why they're not able to conduct electricity even if I attach some battery with such a material? So the simple, a very simple reason behind that is that in comparison to conductors, the electrons available in the plastic material are not free to move. So students, you must note down very carefully, the electron which is available in the plastic material is not free to move. So they are not like a free charges. So I will write the reason. Since the electron in an insulator like plastic is not free to move, so they're not able to conduct electricity. This is the one point in the note. Second point is that actually that electron is very much bound with the nucleus. So if this is bound with the nucleus, then we required a very large amount of a battery which can provide a huge potential difference, which able to pull those electrons and tries to move in the material. So the problem is that by applying such a heavy battery, which you can suppose to conduct electricity in the plastic, so we will not get benefit by just moving those electrons in the plastic, because we have so many material which can easily conduct electricity. So in that sense, we should know these regions also. If we able to create such a huge amount of potential difference through the battery, which can just pull out those electrons which are very much bound to the nucleus inside the plastic material. So we even to be able to create such kind of potential difference, then we able to even conduct electricity in the plastic. In that sense, I am saying. So try to understand this point. So at conceptual level, we will say we need a very huge battery which can conduct electricity through even with plastics. But at long run, it will be not beneficial. Long run, or you can say, or practically in use, it is not beneficial. Right? Another one more point I will take here. Like if I consider a wood material, suppose this is a wood material. This wood material will not conduct electricity if I just attach a simple cell with it. So suppose a 5-volt cell I attach here. I'm giving you some practical examples which I have encountered in my experience. So this will help you to develop some conceptual level about the about this chapter, your electric potential and capacitance, which will further help you in your next chapter coming, that is your current electricity. So in the figure one, this wood material will not able to conduct electricity. But in second case, if we put this wood material into a water, and then again attach with 5-volt battery, then you can see now this material of wood with water deep will start conducting electricity. So try to understand these things, that in this way even that wood can conduct electricity, but we have made some changes in that, because since water is a good conducting material, so now in this figure it able to conduct electricity. Now further, I will say fourth point. You will study further in detail about energy band theory of solids in your chapter 14, where you will be further get clarity that why conductor and insulator behave like that. So now I'm defining another type of material called as semiconductors. The materials having their conductivity between conductors and insulators are called as semiconductors. Example is like silicon and germanium. This kind of material behave like a semiconductors. You will study about this semiconductor material in chapter 14. So now we have a next topic to discuss, free charges and bound charges in a conductor. You see, if I make an atom of a conductor, so you must aware this concept from your chemistry that we have a nucleus. In the nucleus we have a proton and neutron, and at outside we have electrons. So few electrons exist inside the inner shell, few electrons exist in the outer shell. So actually these outer electrons are loosely bound with nucleus, loosely bound with nucleus. So they are free to move in a material when some external electric field is applied. So these kind of charges are called as free charges. Are called as free charges. and note these free charges help in conducting electricity in conductors. So in this case, we can refer the inner electrons like a bound charges, inner electrons, or we can say these protons, these can act as a bound charges. This will also act as a bound charges. Why we are saying it bound charges? Because these charges cannot participate in electricity. These electrons cannot participate in electricity, but those are at the outer end, they are free to move, so they able to conduct electricity, so they are called as the free charges, and these are called as bound charges. So this is the meaning of this topic, free charges and bound charges in a conductor. So I hope you understood up to this. So our next topic is discussion about dielectrics. So first of all, its definition: the material which do not conduct electricity are called as dielectrics. So, or simply we can say insulators are also named as dielectrics. So very much clear with this meaning. What do you mean by dielectrics? So further we have a types of dielectrics. We can divide dielectrics in two category. One is called as polar molecule dielectrics, and second is non-polar molecule dielectrics. So we will define each one. Define polar molecules. Dielectrics. A molecule in which there is separation between center of positive charges and center of negative charges. So as you know from the definition of dipole moment, if there exists two charges like this minus q and plus q separated by some distance, say 2a, so there must be dipole moment in this case and having direction from minus q to plus q side. So we have defined a polar molecule dielectrics like molecule in which there is a separation between center of positive charge and center of negative charge, center of negative charge, then such a material is called as polar dielectrics materials or molecules. So example we can take like the HCl molecule or the water molecule behave like a polar molecules. So what is important to note in this category, the polar molecules have permanent dipole moment. This is to be remembered in the mind. Next, I will define non-polar molecules. Dielectrics so in comparison to that you can frame its definition by yourself also. The molecule in which center of positive and negative charge coexist. So due to that, there will be zero dipole moment associated with non-polar molecules. Examples are like hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, etc. See here, we have an example of non-polar and polar molecules. You can see in this case, the two hydrogen molecules we have shown here, but the concept is that suppose in this case, we assume the center of the positive charge. How we have to assume the center of the positive charge? It is like the concept of center of mass. Like in the class 11, we calculate the center of mass of the two mass particle. So in that way, if there is some positive charge here and there is some positive charge here, then their center of charges will lie you can say assumed somewhat here. So similarly, their negative charges, if I assume this as a positive, then their negative will coincide here. So if positive negative coincide, so there is no separation of charges and dipole moment becomes zero in this case. So the same example you can understood in the case of CO2 molecule also. So this is also the one of the example of nonpolar CO2 molecule. But in this case you can see its structure also. Due to the different structure also, their positive and negative charges in this case are not coincide and they are separated. So in this case, what happens? In this case, you can assume like this, minus Q is here and plus Q is here, and there is some separation between the charges. So due to this separation, there must exist a dipole moment. So this is the direction of the dipole moment. Okay, and in case of water, how to understand the water case as a polar molecule? In case of water, there we will assume a minus 2e charge, there you assume a plus e charge and a plus e charge. So this water molecule will be a combination of two dipoles. The one dipole will exist in this way, having the dipole moment P1, and the second dipole will exist in this direction, having the dipole moment P2. So the net dipole moment we need to be calculated using a parallelogram law. So their net dipole moment will be calculated in this way. So their this will be their P net in case of water molecule. So this is the example we have understood for polar and non-polar molecules, right? I hope these things are very much clear with you. Now we will move on to the next topic. Okay, students, so now we will discuss our next topic called as electric polarization. This is very important in case of dielectrics. So for this, I will first consider a dielectric material of non-polar kind. Dielectric non-polar material as in figure. So suppose this is a dielectric of non-polar material. So here how we will show inside, we will show in this way. Their positive and negative charges coincide, as we have seen in case of their definition, their positive negative charges coincide. So we have shown it like this. Now see, in this first figure, what will be the P net of this material? So this will be zero. So the P net of this material is zero. As we have seen, there is no separation of positive negative charges. So we will say this material without external field. Now, if the same material is put it inside an external field, then what will happen? So we will see, if the same material is put it in an external field, so how we can create such a kind of field? This can be created by using two parallel plates, one with positive charge, another with negative charge. So two parallel plates can create such kind of field. In such a field, if you place this material, so what will happen? We know from the previous section of our chapters that a charge placed inside electric field will get a Coulomb force over it. So these positive and negative charges will also experience Coulomb force inside the electric field, due to which their positive and negative center of charges will be displaced. So due to this separation, there are charges, due to this separation, there will be a situation of like this. So this I am showing now. You can see the separation of negative and positive charges. So in this way we will make it. The point is very much clear. The negative charges due to electrons will be towards the positive plate, and the positive charges will be towards the negative plate. So this is the situation we are showing you with electric field effect. So you can see in the first figure there is a zero net dipole moment, but in the second figure you will agree that there must exist a non-zero dipole moment. Why there will be a non-zero dipole moment? Because very much clear that charges are separated here, so there must be the individual dipole moment of each molecule. If there will be individual dipole moment of each molecule, so what will be the total dipole moment? In non-zero value. So I hope you understood this concept. So we have seen With the help of electric field, we able to separate charges and be able to create a non-zero dipole moment inside the material. Such a phenomena, such a behavior of the material with the help of electric field is called as electric polarization. So now I can write the definition of electric polarization here. Define electric polarization so the phenomenon of separating positive and negative charges inside a dielectric material and they start giving non-zero dipole moment is called as electric polarization. Mathematically, how we define electric polarization? Electric polarization is net dipole moment of dielectric slab per unit volume. So understood these lines very carefully. So it is a net dipole moment of a dielectric slab per unit volume it is denoted by a symbol capital P and it is a vector quantity, right? So it is a vector quantity. So very much clear, the direction of P will be same as direction of dipole moment. See further in this picture, which is very important to understand. At these end, we have a induced negative charges due to this electric polarization effect, and at this end, we have a positive charges due to polarization effect. This is our dielectric slab. So these negative charges are called as induced charges, and these will be positive induced charges. Remember, here I have taken a surface charge density. This is surface charge density as you know, three types of density exist: lambda, sigma, and rho. This one is linear charge density. This is surface charge density. And this is volume charge density. So you must be thinking that why there will be a surface charge density, and is that some volume charge density also exists inside this dielectric slab? So these are the important questions here which needs to be answered. So see, if we go to the definition of a surface charge density, then it says charge per unit area. So when you check this slab surface area, you will find here so many negative charge distribution. So it is very much clear that this is a situation of the charge per unit area. So there must be a surface charge density. Similarly, you can understood the positive surface charge density here, as we have explained this. Now the second part is that, is there any volume charge density also exists? So regarding that, if we consider, suppose any volume of this material, consider small volume, but remember this small volume is at macroscopic level. I am saying small volume, but in actual, in this small volume, there will be so many non-polar molecules available. Here, so many non-polar molecules will be present, but you will see if there is a negative charge, then there is positive charge also in the molecule. You will agree, if there is a negative, there is positive also. There is a negative, there is positive also. So if I just talk about, suppose as an example of this volume, so you will see that the total positive charge will cancel out with the total negative charge. So that's why when you go for calculation of your volume charge density, which is Q divided by volume, so your answer will be zero. So this explanation shows that there will not exist any volume charge density. So hope this point is very much clear with you. Now we will consider the case of polar dielectrics. So again, first we consider without electric field effect. So just taken a material of polar dielectric. And as in the definition we have discussed that the polar dielectric molecule having permanent dipole moment. So I'm showing that molecules. But you can see very much clear without electric field effect situation, there exists permanent dipole moment. Each one having their individual dipole moment, I'm showing it. Like this. We can show each dipole moment, but all these dipole moment are randomly arranged. So when we calculate their net dipole moment of the whole material, this will comes out to be zero because of their random direction. So this is an important point here. In spite of having their individual dipole moment, but due to the random direction, we are overall getting P net zero. So again, we have a benefit of having the effect of electric polarization here. When we put this material into some external electric field, these molecules which are initially arranged in the different direction, they will get aligned in the direction of field. So we will see this situation in the second figure with electric field effect. So suppose the electric field is present like this. Again, this will be available with the help of two sheets, positive and negative. So what will happen? You must have done earlier torque acting on dipole. When placed in external field. So the formula for that torque is P cross E. So by using this concept, each molecule, each polar molecule will experience a torque. And due to that torque, this torque will try to align the molecule in the direction of electric field. Fine. So all molecules will be try to arrange in this way. But still here important to note down that few molecules will not completely align themselves because of thermal agitations. So I will write it here in note, very important note. Few molecules will still not align themselves due to thermal agitations. Agitations means vibrations due to the thermal energy available at the given temperature at which this material is placed. So we can say here, if we reduce the temperature, then these thermal agitations will reduce and there will be a best situation of alignment. But still there are so many material here will be completely aligned. So due to that, you will easily get negative charges at the left side. They will be again called as induced charges. And this side you will get positive. They're called as sigma p. And again the same concept, if you consider here any volume of this portion, they will not have rho value. So in that way, this material will only exist in negative layer of induced charges, a positive layer of induced charges. And remember these negative these induced charges are also called as bound charges. And remember, the charges on these plates, if I assume this as a plus Q charge and this as a minus Q charge, then these positive and negative charges are actually called as free charges. So this is very important to understand these terms. What do you mean by induced charges? What do you mean by bound charges? And what do you mean by the free charges? Okay. Now we will see electric field strength inside dielectric slab or material due to electric polarization effect. So consider two plates, one is positive, another is negative, so that we are having some uniform external field available with us, limit as E naught, and take a dielectric material of any kind. This is valid for any kind of dielectric slab, the discussion we are doing. So this is a dielectric slab. So we know due to the polarization, there will be negative charges induces, there will be a positive charges induces, as we have seen in the polarization effect. So this we assume minus sigma p. This is plus sigma p. So due to these negative and positive charges separation, you will agree that there will be some field will exist due to these bound charges. due to these bound charges of positive and negative layer, there must exist some electric field, and it is named as EP, the field inside dielectric slab due to bound charges. So you can see inside the dielectric material we have a two kind of electric field. One is the external field, another is the polarizing field. So what is the net electric field inside the dielectric slab? It will be the vector sum of these two electric field, and being they are in the opposite direction, so there will be a subtraction. So you will agree that the net field, I let E as the net field. Inside the dielectric slab. So it is very much clear that this will be the subtraction of E naught minus EP. So this is the one point we have to keep in mind for the future. And second point here is that it is also found that the relation of this net electric field with the help of dielectric constant value. So also you remember this relation from the previous section of the chapter, that how a dielectric material can affect the electric field inside it. So we know that the electric field inside will reduced by the amount of epsilon r value, where epsilon r stands for relative electric permittivity of dielectric medium. So this is the second point to be remembered. Now further, it is also found that the electric polarization vector P is given by this value. Here we have introduced another new constant. Is called as electric susceptibility of dielectric material. So it is a constant value. It is a constant value and it will characterize a material with its polarization property. Which means that is this symbol is named as chi. So more value implies more polarization effect in material. Okay, so this is the points related to dielectric polarization you have to keep in your mind. Now we will see our next topic, which is again very important to make concept regarding electric polarization. So it is effect of electric polarization on Gauss law. So you people must remember Gauss law in your chapter 1. So we will see what is the effect of electric polarization on Gauss law. So first I consider two parallel plates with one having positive charge, another having negative charge. So suppose I am interested in calculating electric field here at this location, suppose O. So I can assume a Gaussian surface like this, which can pass through O. Gaussian surface. Name this charge as plus Q and this as minus Q. And these are free charges, remember, free charges. So when we apply Gauss law, by using Gauss law, which you know, E dot dA over the Q enclosed by epsilon naught. So you can see in this Gaussian surface, what is Q enclosed? Of Q amount. And since electric field here is uniform, so what will be of this value? It should be EA cos 0 Q by epsilon naught, and the answer will be Q by A epsilon naught. Make it equation number 1. Okay. Now this is the electric field which is available at this point O. So I can show this here also. This is E naught. And now I consider this situation by inserting a dielectric material between here. So now we insert a dielectric material between two charged conductors. So see this. Again, here positive charges exist, here negative. This is plus Q, minus Q. They are free charges. And I will put a dielectric slab here. The external field exists in this direction. And we know due to the polarization effect, there will be induced charges, and we know this is named as minus sigma P. In the form of charges, I will say, suppose it is minus Q dash, which is plus Q dash. These are the bound charges. Remember, this is free charges. So now again I consider the same point O, and for calculating electric field at this point O again, okay, so this will be a different electric field. As we know, inside the dielectric, electric field get reduced. So we can again calculate this electric field with the help of Gauss law. So now draw a Gaussian surface like this and passing from that point. So this is the Gaussian surface. So when we apply this Gauss law in this situation now, we have a E dot dA, Q enclosed by epsilon naught. So you can see again, E will be constant. And this will be EA cos 0 situation. And what is important here to note down, what will be the Q enclosed charge inside this Gaussian surface. So that is interesting to be note down. So you can see in this Gaussian surface, this plus Q is also coming, as well as this minus Q dash is also coming. So by the definition, there should be the net charge which is enclosed by this Gaussian surface. So it should be Q minus Q dash. So it is important to note down how I am writing this Q enclosed charge. Now you see, I have this situation. Cos 0 is taken as 1. So Q divided by epsilon naught A minus Q dot divided by epsilon naught A. Make it equation number 2. So further, we know, as I have told you earlier, what will be the electric field inside dielectric with the help of relative electric permittivity value. And remember, this I have told you what relative electric permittivity, and this is also known as a more familiar term. If people remember, it is also called as dielectric constant. So put 3 into, put equation 3 in 2, what we get? We get E value as E naught by, this is epsilon r. So E naught by epsilon r Q over epsilon naught A minus Q dash over epsilon naught A. So understand up to this all steps very carefully. I have made all the steps very much clear. So now make it this equation number 4 and put value of this E naught from equation 1. So how much is E naught? E naught is Q by A epsilon naught. Q by A epsilon naught and divided by epsilon r. From 1 I have taken the help. So what will be this? QA epsilon naught So we can see here epsilon naught A will be cancelled out. And Q dash I am taking to this side. Taking Q common. So this is the expression which we have made, which is very, very important. In this topic, to get this topic more clear, so this Q dash is, again I remind you, this is bound charge, this Q is free charge, and this Q is dielectric constant value. So I make this equation as 5. You see, you may not find this relation in your NCERT, but for the clarity of this topic, very much clear, this is very important to analyze such kind of situations, right? So this implies very much clearly that Q dash will be always less than Q, because epsilon r for the material other than air or a vacuum, it will be always greater than 1. So in that situation you will find this dash to be the bound charges to be always less than q. So we can make a further a case if there is, suppose, no dielectric material, then equation 5 becomes you see that is a situation of vacuum. So in vacuum epsilon r is 1, so you can see we have zero bound charges. So situation give us a very very clear picture. So now I can write a Gauss law in case of dielectric. Now we able to write a Gauss law form with dielectric material inside as E dot dA over Q net over epsilon naught. And what is Q net R? Our Q net value is Q minus Q dash, as we have seen earlier. Q minus Q dash. So this is the form which can be utilized directly for applying Gauss law in case of dielectric material. So I hope in today's lecture all the topics I able to clear you very much. So in case you find any difficulty or any doubt in any topic, or you have any query, you can write a comment and I will try to answer your queries. So thank you so much. With this, we end this lecture.